In this video, we'll cover how to set up a quiz, including the various settings available, as well as how to add questions. To create a quiz in Moodle, turn editing on and click Add Activity or Resource, then select Quiz. Give your quiz a name and a description, then scroll down to change the various settings. First up is the Timing tab. Here you can select when to open and close the quiz by checking the Enable box and changing the date and time. You can also set a time limit for how long students have once they begin the quiz. You have three options for what happens when time expires on the quiz, but it's recommended you leave it as is, so attempts are submitted automatically when the time ends. Under Grade, we should select the category this quiz is going into. The grade to pass can be set if you want it to be something other than the standard grading system. The third option, Attempts Allowed, can be set here from 1 to 10 or even unlimited. Lastly, you have grading method, which defaults to the highest grade out of all their attempts, but you can also average it or take the first or last attempt. Layout gives you options on how many questions are displayed before the student must go to the next page. It defaults to one question per page, but if you'd rather students be able to freely scroll through the whole quiz, you can set it to never, all questions on one page. This is most likely the most accessible option and is therefore recommended. Next is question behavior. We can change whether we want answers to be shuffled or not. You can also choose how students receive feedback on these questions. Is it deferred to the end of the quiz, or is it immediately after the answer? Lastly, let's take a look at the review section. Here you can go through and select what information you want students to see and when they can see it. The During Attempt section is going to be grayed out unless you set the question behavior to immediate feedback and not deferred. If you did not set a close date for the quiz, then the last section will be grayed out as well, so be sure to set that first. There are other settings available, but if you have questions beyond what's covered here, please contact the Office of Online and Distance Learning. Now, let's hit Save and Display to get into the quiz itself. Hit the Add Question button to start building your quiz. To add questions, find the Add button on the right and then click a new question. Here you'll see all the different types of questions you can add. Let's start with the simple multiple choice. Click that option and then click Add. Give your question a name first and then use the question text field to add the question itself. Scroll down and change the default mark if you want the question to be worth more. You can add general feedback here for the question that all students would see, but you can also add feedback later on in relation to a specific answer choice. Your questions can allow for multiple answers or just one. Here, you can shuffle the choices on this specific question, but you'll need to also have enabled this setting in the overall quiz settings that we discussed earlier. Next is where we include our answer choices. Enter those in the choice fields, then be sure to select a grade for each choice. You can make it so one answer is worth 100% of the points, or no points by selecting none. You can also award partial credit. Here is where you can also add feedback for each answer choice. Leave any unused answer choices blank. Or if you need more, click the Blanks for Three More Choices button. Click Save Changes when you're finished editing your question. Now you can click the Add button to make more questions. Be aware you have many different types such as short answer or even essay questions. Once you have multiple questions, you can do some reorganizing if you'd like. You can check the Shuffle box on the right to shuffle the order of the questions. You can select Repaginate towards the left to change how many questions are on each page, and we can also click and drag questions to change the order. Before you're done, make sure your maximum grade matches the total number of points. You can adjust the point values of each question from this page by clicking on the pencil icon on the right. One last note. When you go back to the quiz page, you won't see the Add Question button here anymore after you've already added questions. To edit your questions, scroll down to the Quiz Administration section on the left and then click Questions. There's a lot about quizzes we didn't cover here, so if you have any other questions or concerns about quizzes, please reach out to the Office of Online and Distance Learning. Thanks for watching.